How it is important in diesel engine? So ignition delay. Ignition delay. It affects the combustion. It affects the performance, that means output. It affects the ability to start the engine. To start engine and the knocking and the black smoke. This we'll see. Ignition delay, what does it mean? I am giving the fuel. So the A point is the fuel injection and B point is ignition. And somewhere, so in the second, this is the first case and this is the second case. In another case, what is there? A is the combustion here. Combustion is a fuel injection here and injection and combustion is here. So that is ignition delay. So here ignition delay D1 and here ignition delay D2. Obviously, in case of 2, ignition delay is more. What actually mean? I am giving the fuel, but fuel is not burning. Here also, I am giving the fuel, but fuel has burned there. And here, I am giving the fuel, and fuel has burned there. Now you say, in which cases the pressure rise will be more? In these cases, what is the accumulated amount of fuel is more, and here the accumulated of oil is less, because I have started the fuel here and combustion is taking place, so much of fuel. But here you see time period is more, so more amount of fuel has accumulated, suddenly all fuel has burned. So if the P1 is here peak pressure and P2 is the peak pressure, then obviously P2 must be greater than P1. Why? Because here the amount of unburned fuel, accumulated fuel is more. I am giving the fuel, is not burning, suddenly burned. So amount of fuel was more. So that's why pressure rise will be very high. And here pressure rise will be less. So that's the delay period. So if the, suppose the delay period will be more, then you will find to start the engine. Because the burning is not taking place. Delay period is more. So that will affect the delay period. If the delay period is more, it is not burning, black smoke will come. If the delay period is more pressure rise, it will cause the knocking of the engine. Obviously, the performance, if it is not burning, some amount of fuel will go. So performance and combustion, everything will affect. So this is the important. Now you see how the ignition delay depends on some factors. So ignition delay is very important in diesel engine as far as combustion, performance, ability to start engine, knocking and the exhaust smoke, black smokes. So ignition delay is very important. Now, what do you feel? In diesel engine, ignition delay should be more or less? This period should be more or, so A, 1 is good or 2 is good as far as diesel is concerned? Ignition delay should be less or ignition delay should be more? Hello. So ignition delay should be less in diesel engine. Ignition delay should be less, because then otherwise there will not be. If there is ignition delay is more amount of accumulated fuel is there, and there is a sudden burning, uncontrolled combustion is more. So in diesel engine, so I need that ignition delay should be as small as possible. Okay. So also, chemical delay to our highest. Chemical delay amar upar hath nahi. Chemical delay, I am coming. That, what is the factors I am coming. But in diesel engine, chemical total delay, that means ignition delay and chemical delay, both combinedly, ignition delay should be as small as possible. Because we are giving the fuel and it should burn immediately. And there should not be any accumulated. Accumulated oil. If there is accumulated oil, it is not burning. And if it burns suddenly, then whole amount of oil will burn and the pressure rise will be very high. There will be vibration in the engine. So in the diesel engine, I need the delay period, that is the ignition delay, should be as small as possible. Also, another thing I need, the fuel. Acha, diesel engine, diesel fuel, how we are defining diesel fuel? What is the diesel fuel? Diesel fuel, there's a, let us say, then you talked it, chemical delay. Diesel fuel, how we are characteristics? By Seaton number. By Seaton number. Seaton number. And in case of petrol, that is a petrol, what's the number? Octane number. Octane number. So higher the Seaton number, delay period will reduce. Okay, but in case of octane number, higher the octane number, in case of petrol engine, higher the octane number, delay period will increase. Because in petrol engine, to avoid the locking, the ignition delay should be more. But in diesel engine, to avoid the knocking, we'll see that your delay period should be less. That means Seaton number should be high. So higher the Seaton number, the delay period is less. And also higher the Seaton number, self ignition temperature. So higher the Seaton number, less the self ignition temperature. And here the higher the octane number, self ignition temperature is higher. Because in diesel engine, diesel fuel, I need the self ignition should be less. Self ignition temperature should be less. That's why self ignition temperature of the diesel is nearly 240 and self ignition of petrol is 280. So I want that self ignition temperature or higher the Seaton number. Now if I use the bad Seaton number, if I say very low Seaton number, what will happen? I use a diesel, what is a very low Seaton number. Very low Seaton number. If the low Seaton number, then what will the delay period will increase? Delay period will, there is a more accumulated, there is a self ignition temperature will be also higher. So there will be more accumulation of fuel inside the petrol, inside the engine. Then that means whatever the diesel we are giving inside the engine, it is not burning. Why? Because delay period is more, self ignition temperature is also high. So burning is not taking place, and suddenly some point of time the ignition temperature has reached, then it suddenly combustion will take place. So that's why in diesel fuel, if you have to the chemical delay, if to reduce the chemical delay, what I have to take that diesel of higher Seaton number. Okay, diesel of higher Seaton number. If we can take the diesel of higher Seaton number, then I can reduce the ignition delay, chemical ignition delay. Okay, what are the other factors? Let us see. Fuel I have. So in diesel fuel, one thing that we have mentioned, that its self ignition should be as low as possible, and its delay period also should be as low. But petrol is just opposite. In petrol, delay should be as high as possible and self ignition should be as high as possible. Now, what is the other factors of ignition delay? Now I have to discuss the knocking also. Knocking is a news. Now, so other factors, let us discuss very briefly. Other factors in ignition delay. Ignition delay, factors ignition delay. Let me, we have discussed about the compression ratio. Compression ratio. What will happen? If the compression ratio is high, then mixing will be better, and then delay period will reduce. If the engine speed n rpm is high, then delay period will decrease. I am writing very shortly. So n means rpm, d means delay period will reduce. Now three, if the atomization pressures, that is the nozzle injector pressures, there is the atomization pressure is high, then delay period is also decreased, because there will be more mixing
or I want that delay period in the diesel engine, delay period should be less. So this is the ways I have to increase the compression ratio, I have to increase the RPM, I have to give the atomization pressures, then output. If this output is there, output increases, diesel period, the delay will also. Then quality of the fuel that we have discussed. Quality of fuel. That is a better Cetan number. Is a better Cetan number, delay period will decrease. That we have discussed, Cetan number. And obviously, other things are intake pressure. That means atmospheric pressure is high, delay period will also reduce. If the intake temperature is high, delay period is also reduced. Delay period is also reduced. Now, this is the normal combustion we have discussed. Now let us go to the knocking or abnormal combustion in CI engines. So this is any doubt here. So okay. Now let us go to the abnormal knocking. How it is happening?